that tune. Dick Witts, Margox, here's your clue. You can hear this tune every Thursday at 10:30 on Granada.
I'll name that tune in 3.
I'll name that tune in 2.
I'll name that tune in 1.
I'll name that tune in nought.
Margox, here is your not note. Okay, Margox, name that tune.
It's Love Fever by the Munich Machine, otherwise known as the What's On Theme. He went away, you hung around and bothered me every night. But I wouldn't go out with you, 'cause you said things that weren't very nice. My boyfriend's back and you're gonna be in trouble. Hey, love, hey, love. When you see him coming, better count out on the double. Hey, love, hey, love. You've been telling lies that I was untrue.
Hey, love, my boyfriend.
So look out now, 'cause he's coming after you.
Hey, love, hey, love.
Hey, he knows I wasn't loving.
Hey, he knows that you've been trying.
Good evening and welcome. That splendid group of Liverpudlians are called Betty Bright and the Illuminations, with a snatch of their last single. New singles coming up later, as does my special guest, Mr. Robert Powell, who will be giving me the lowdown on the latest remake of the 39 Steps, which at long last opens in the Northwest on Sunday week. Also a special Dick Witts report on one of the Northwest's most adventurous cinemas. Plus, of course, Margox, who named our What's On tune for you a moment ago. Lots of you have asked us about it, so once again, it's Love Fever by the Munich Machine off their fine album, White as Shade of Pale. An album which also gave us this next 3 seconds worth of music.
Have you got a message for your British fans or your fans in Manchester?
Oh, we love them.
You bet. Yeah. We really do.
Just hope that we can do them a good job tonight.
Yeah. You know, when you come to a country, you don't know exactly what the response is going to be, or the reception, or how they're going to like you. And I must say that we're just really thrilled and happy with the response they've given us, and we really do appreciate it.
You bet.
It really is great.
They seem like nice boys.
Thank you.
That's the Osmonds, delighted to be in Manchester in '72. And I bet they're just as delighted to be back again, playing at the Apollo on Monday, their only concert outside London.
You don't worry for me, 'cause I'm alright. I don't want you to tell me it's time to come home. I don't care what you say anymore, this is my life.
Is his kind of life, Billy Joel, who's playing Manchester's Apollo on February the 22nd as his only Northwest gig. But a word of warning, so many people have rung us up to ask about this concert that we're taking this chance to let you know that in fact it's sold out. No tickets left for Billy Joel. Remember Matthew's Southern Comfort? No, not the drink, the group. This lad led to success with his big hit Woodstock. Well, Ian Matthews is no longer in the musical first division in Britain, but he's trying again. And this Saturday, you can see him at Manchester University Students' Union. Not so much a still life, more a landscape. Jazz rockers' landscape must have a lot going for them. The Arts Council are sponsoring their tour to see if our money's being well spent when Landscape paints a musical picture or two at the Band on the Wall, Swan Street in Manchester, next Thursday, the 1st of February. And still on the subject of music, Dick Witts insists that I tell you about 2 special events. A rare Northwest appearance by one of the world's finest string quartets, the Guarneri String Quartet from America. They make a very welcome visit to Manchester's Royal Northern College of Music next Wednesday at 7:30. And the other, top pianist Peter O'Hagan's return visit to his native Liverpool tomorrow to play the best of music from the 40s, the 1740s and 1940s, that is, at the Pool's Blue Coat Hall at 7:45. And still with nostalgia in mind, let's turn to films and the third version of John Buchan's classic thriller, The 39 Steps, which opens in the Northwest Sunday week. In 1914 London, a British intelligence officer, played by John Mills, has unearthed a plot being hatched to start World War I. But before he can pass on his info, he's bumped off, and the police, headed by grim Eric Porter, get tangled up in a plot with international ramifications. Plunged into the midst of these dirty deeds is dashing Richard Hannay, Salford's own Robert Powell, who's chased across Scotland by the police, foreign heavies, and others.
What are you doing?
Doing? It's a wager.
Wager?
Yes.
What sort of wager?
I have 500 guineas on it.
That's going up pretty strong.
What's it about?
Well, I have these two friends who bet me that given an hour's start, I couldn't reach Inverness before they caught me.
A manhunt? Yes. How marvellous.
Enormously exhilarating. Sleeping rough, changing clothes with a tramp to throw them off the scent. If you forgive the expression. However, not only do I smell to high heaven, I am extremely hungry.
Oh, David, you must come back for refreshments.
What? Oh, yes, yes, of course. I'm Hamilton. This is Miss Mackenzie.
Lord Rowan.
Royce. Dick Royce.
How do you do? Right, everybody, let's get back to cars.
The quick thinking Robert Powell is here now. There's been the classic Hitchcock version of 39 Steps, the Kenneth Moore version, now your version. Is it going to stand up, you think, a third time?
Only time will tell. I think so. I don't think I would have done it in the first place if I felt it couldn't stand up. I don't think there's any reason why, just because somebody's done something before, you can't do it again. Mm. I mean, just because Gielgud did Hamlet in 1948 brilliantly, it doesn't mean to say I can't have a go now. Hitchcock took the bare bones of a story and invented his own film around those bones. And we've done exactly the same thing. We haven't used any of Hitchcock's own invention, and we've set it back in 1914. I think it holds.
You play a smashing hero. You play an old-fashioned kind of hero, don't you? It's not your sort of James Bond hero, is it?
No, he's just an ordinary fella who happens to find himself involved in circumstances beyond his control. That's quite a nice part to play, really. Ordinary people involved in extraordinary circumstances.
Well, you do get up to extraordinary circumstances. Let's have a look at one of the circumstances in the film. If you watch up there, you're going to see yourself, Robert, in just a couple of seconds. It must have been a very tough film physically, was it, Robert?
It's the hardest film I've ever done physically. I never stopped running or dangling throughout the whole piece.
It's a dangler, is it?
Oh, yeah, I dangle from every conceivable object around.
I know you're going to do other things, not only act, you're going to write and become a producer. A man with a mission, I saw you described as, who's going to bring romance back to the cinema. That sounds awful, tell me.
Did I say that?
Yeah.
I feel very strongly that a lot of movies that are made nowadays are made for very specific, very tiny audiences, and they're not we're missing out on a unit, which is a family unit, which is Mum and Dad being able to take the kids and Gran all to the movies for a Saturday night out. And I think there's something missing too. We're not telling stories anymore. This is what I like about 39 Steps. It's a story. It has a beginning, a middle, and an end, and characters that people can recognise.
So it's for commercial rather than moral reasons. You're not aligning yourself with Mrs. Whitehouse, are you? Against sex and violence in films?
No, not at all. I think, I mean, I've done them. I think there's room for it.
Are you going to do more of them?
Yes. Are you? Nobody's seen that one yet.
Robert Powell, thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, Robert Powell. Now, for the first time at What's On, we have to take a commercial break. We'll be right back in just a moment. Don't go away.
Do you ever get that dull, stuffed-up feeling when you can't whip up any zest for living? Clogged-up nose, aching mind, ratty hair? You've tried everything, but nothing seems to work. Have you tried the Royal Liverpool Philharmonic Orchestra? They really work. Those wonderful melodies speed recovery like nothing else. So unplug your tubes. Go see the Royal Liverpool Philharmonic Orchestra play music by Beethoven, Schubert, and Spohr at the Philharmonic Hall, Liverpool on Saturday at 7:30. Chase away that bunged up misery.
It's true. It really works.
Yes, sir. Tunes help you breathe more easily.
Welcome back to part two, Bunged Up or No? And you're just in time for our theatre roundup. After book sales of over 50 million, the famous Peanuts cartoon strip takes to the stage with Liverpool's Playhouse's upstairs production of You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown. Performances from Wednesday, 31st of January, to Saturday, February the 17th. The cast of the Duke's Playhouse, the long and the short and the tall, getting the once-over from a real-life army sergeant. This enormously powerful war play, which is on at Lancaster's Duke's Playhouse from January the 31st to February the 24th. And here's a real turnaround. Theatre critic Diana Harker turns theatre director for Manchester's Library Theatre production of Abigail's Party from January the 31st to February the 24th. Radio City DJ Norman Thomas making his point in Aladdin. Kirby's Pento's been hit by cancelled schools' parties because of the fuel crisis. So give it your support at the Kirby Suite, Cherryfield Drive, Kirby, tomorrow and on Saturday when there's also a matinee. We've turned Dick Witts onto the streets this week to look at a special cinema.
Manchester. It even sounds spliced together. I felt so bad I lit a fag, and I don't smoke. I had a hangover. Too many bad films. But sex films are as false as a stripper's eyelash. I'd rather make porn than watch it. God, life was getting as tedious as the Superman credits. I moved down Peter Street. Now this looked like a place for some action, but behind me, a hippie cortina flashed past. A leaflet fell off the back of it. I picked it up like it was the drop in frenzy. A-A-B-E-N? What did it mean? An actress in a Bergman film? The YMCA looked like a place for dummies, but the Aaben was a silver screen and I needed a fix. I held my map and my breath. Aaben, Hulme, southwest, half a mile. I walked along Deansgate to the first roundabout. No sign of the Aaben. I checked the map. Chilton Road down to Wally Range. I moved quick. I was sniffing the celluloid. I stopped by the first traffic lights down Chilton Road. Would I find the A-A-B-E-N before it turned into B-I-N-G-O? Yes, it's round here, round Jackson's Crescent in the north of Hulme. I ran, only two verses of As Time Goes By from the city centre. Round the crescent, like a scene from Now, funny how they don't make films of council estates. But there it is. Like a warehouse. Like a Methodist chapel. Like a relic. Like a misprint. I marched over like John Mills in The Desert Rats. I passed by the hippie cortina parked at the entrance. Was this fate like in Close Encounters?
Oh, what's the best one?
Two Women, a cheap remake of the Altman flick. But there were four cinemas in the place. Four! I'm not greedy. I took tickets for three. I asked what was the best. She told me straight. Film critics don't often work in a box office. She asked me where I wanted to sit. On seats, I suggested. She made a suggestion, but I let it ride. I went over to number two. I went through to customs control. Nothing to declare but caution and a ticket. They tore through both. The black hit me, and I saw...
You want to, babe. I'm not the one you need. You say you're looking for someone. Protect you and defend you, whether you are right or wrong. Someone to open each and every door.
A film, the first of the day, and two out of three to go. I had to know more. I had to see the face behind the silver screen, the friend of the film freaks, the manager.
Hello.
Mr. Kelson. I crouched in his presence. He had more pens than a sheep farmer. I said I was a film junkie. I needed the hard stuff, something to bite the brain aside from oxygen. He spoke happy like a man who didn't owe money. He said he had four a week, sometimes more. I gave him the third degree. Who chose them? The customers sent in requests. Mr. Tattersall at head office got them as soon as he could. How long had the album been going? 5 years. Before that, bingo. From bingo, two films? A success story. I needed a drink. He took me to the bar, but we took a coffee. I had two more films to go. I told him about the leaflet. He told me of his mailing list, one a month with a film guide. I asked him about the word Aaben. He smiled. It's Danish for open. But it was time for another film. He said, take your coffee in, rattle the cup in the hot bits. I went through the customs and saw...
And what seems to be the trouble with your marriage, Mr. Pewty?
Well, it all started when we first went to Brighton on holiday together. Deirdre, that's my wife, and I have always been very close companions, and I never particularly anticipated any marital strife. Indeed, the very idea of consulting a professional marital advisor has always been of the greatest repugnance to me. Although, far be it from me to impugn the nature of your trade or profession.
Do go on.
Oh, well, as I was saying, Deirdre and I have always been very close companions, sharing the interests, the gardening, the sixpenny bottle for the holiday money, and indeed, twice a month of an evening, settling down to do
the films. The coffee felt like coffee, and even the air was made this year. I doubled over to Aaben 4 and through the customs, but they saw red. No smoking in number 4 on Thursdays. Lots of people aren't sold on cancer. I sailed into...
You don't want the nickel?
No.
You don't want it?
No.
All right, I'll take it.
Lucky chance, I'm lucky. In your arms, you open heaven's portal. Here on earth, for this poor mortal, you are my lucky, lucky star.
I felt like a dog on heat. Maybe I looked like one, but I was converted. I'm glad I came, like Brando in Last Tango. I took a pawful of leaflets to pass around the people like an evangelist. I was going back to Granada to tell you all about the big story when the hippie cortina zoomed past like Paul Newman in Butch Cassidy. I ran to put a face to the legs, and that's why I'm not here.
The Aaben Cinema. Fine films and comfy seats. Let's now move from cinema on to the marvellous world of cabaret. Oobla-dee, oobla-da, life goes on for the Marmalade. The string of jolly 60s hits to remember and enjoy when Marmalade and its host of Salford at the Willows from the 1st to the 3rd of February. Just like the Osmonds, the Dooleys are a happy family that have sung their way into many hearts and up the charts. Catch them in action at Fagan's in Manchester from next Monday through to Saturday. Faith Brown, a lovely young lady who does not the cooking and cleaning, but a whole string of convincing impressions from Gracie Fields to Marilyn Monroe. I'd certainly move mountains to see Faith at Jolly's in Stoke-on-Trent from February the 1st to the 3rd. After a few lean years, the Baron Knights are right back in vogue again. Now rather less than youthful, but still the wickedest pop satirists around. The Knights are at the Garter, the Golden One, in Withenshaw that is, this coming Monday, until Saturday. You know, I'm sure Margox is addictive. All week now I've been wondering about shouting, "You're crazy!" I haven't offered some funny looks. But now, as promised, a new cultured Margox.
I'm off to the opera next week. Oh, I just can't describe the thrill I get when the male lead hits high C. Oh, I don't get many high C's in my life. Now and then a low F, but it's not the same, is it? All that drama and passion, my opera glasses get all steamed up in the stalls and my chalk ice melts completely at the grand climax. Well, you get a bit like that when you're involved, don't you? Take the Mikado, it's so uplifting. And take the Turn of the Screw, it's so screwy. But oh, it's a delight when played by the Welsh National Opera Company, who've come straight from the mines to sing at the Theatre Clwyd tomorrow at 7:30. So do try and see the Turn of the Screw, cause it's going straight to Walton Nick after that. Do you know, my dears, I have always wanted to be an opera singer, just like Maria Callas. I mean, she did all right for herself, didn't she? Copping off with that fella who had loads of money in Greek shipping. But if you live in Wirral, here's something to cheer you up. It's been stolen. Seriously, and I say this with suspenders under this skirt, the Wirral County Grammar School, for young ladies that is, are performing Don Giovanni at the school, Heathrow, Bebbington, at 7:30 tomorrow. Don Giovanni played for Argentina in the World Cup. That's one for you sports fans, okay? The thing about opera is that it makes you so well balanced, like my shampoo. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair. I'm going to wash that man right out of my hair and send him on his way to the Bolton Operatic Society, who are performing South Pacific at the Octagon Theatre from the 30th this month to the 10th of February, 7:30 each night. Is there nothing like a dame? Well, nip along to Bolton and they'll tell you, okay? So, do take my advice and go to the opera and you'll discover that Madame Butterfly is not a brothel in Lime Street. Good night.
That's just about it for this week, thanks to Robert Powell. And as promised, stand by for a blast from our sparkling guest group, Betty Bright and the Illuminations, a smashing Liverpool group led by Betty, who used to play with Deaf School. And you can see them tomorrow night at Eric's Club in Liverpool. We're going to play out with her second single, the mid-60s hit, Captain of Your Ship. Ta for watching. Till next week, good night.